Horror and disbelief tonight at the report of four Christian children beheaded at the hands of ISIS militants in Iraq. The leader of the Anglican Church in Baghdad says the children were murdered because they refused to denounce Jesus and convert to Islam. With me, Father Gerald Murray. All right, Father, British Canon Andrew White says the killings happened in a Christian area near Baghdad controlled by ISIS. All of the children were under 15. They refused to say they would follow Muhammad. And the vicar himself has since moved to Israel. What do you know about this, Father?
This is horrendous, but it's in line with what ISIS has been doing in Mosul and Syria and other places. They basically tell Christians, either you convert or we're going to kill you. And many of them fled, but these unfortunate victims in the Baghdad area couldn't flee. They're kids, for crying out loud. And the idea that you convert to a religion because you're threatened with death, this is inimical to reason. It's a horrendous, horrendous crime.
But you know what, Father? I say to myself, these people are psychopaths, sociopaths, but that's too easy.
It is too easy. No, actually, this is a fanatical interpretation of Islam. This is saying that Islam is the only religion, everything else is false, and if you don't agree with us, you're the enemy and we're going to kill you. This is the exact opposite of anything God would reveal. And, you know, thank God for peaceful Muslims who reject it, but we need more of them to speak up.
I don't know where they are, Father. Who have you spoken to lately?
Well, I don't have too much contact with Muslims, but I do know in places like Lebanon and Morocco, there's much more of an entente or an understanding between Christians and Muslims. And it used to be that way in Syria and Iraq. This is the sad thing. Those countries after the war, the fanatics took over and were in big trouble.
Well, you know, even converting, that still is not a guarantee that you're going to live, that some people still think you're an infidel if you do. But, you know, you're a Christian and you read about this and you're outraged. I'm furious. Why isn't more being done? Why do we just say, oh, that's terrible and move on?
Well, part of it is in the Western world, there's an antipathy to Christianity because of Christian morals. You know, we preach a moral code that many of on the left and the liberal side don't like. So they become very silent when it comes to the persecution of Christians. In fact, I remember I was disappointed. I learned more about Yazidis than about Christians when they attack Mosul. I'm in favor of everybody having religious freedom and protection. But for crying out loud, Christianity is the basis of Western civilization. It's under attack. And these are innocent children suffering. It's time for this government in the U.S. and other places.
How about the Pope? I mean, it took him a while to get involved.
Well, the Pope has spoken up, and in fact, some of the, you know, I hope he'll do more of it. And it's true, you know, the Pope is in a difficult position because he doesn't want to create more problems.
He's not in a difficult position. We are his flock. What's difficult about saying that is unacceptable?
Well, you remember when Pope Benedict criticized Muhammad and his religion, that a nun was killed in Somalia. So the Holy See has to worry because they are in a diplomatic position. On the other hand, he's been very clear. ISIS should be stopped. Government should fight it. That really is a good message.
So what do you think in light of all this when Hillary Clinton says that we have to understand and, quote, respect and empathize our enemies?
Well, it's a little bit like hug a thug in criminal justice, you know. You can't do that when it comes to people who are killing innocent children. I mean, think about it. I have kids in my parish. Some man comes in and says, here's a knife, say Muhammad is the one you're going to follow, I'm going to cut your head off. This has to be stopped. Those people need to be stopped.
They do, indeed. Father Murray, thanks so much for being with us this evening. And be sure to join me for a special one-hour justice investigation in the persecution of Christians airing in 2 weeks, Saturday, December 27th, when Father Murray will join us again. Coming up, the one and only...